Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through jitter control, guys. Okay, so basically I am not 100% clear. I'm not 100% clear with this topic, so I'll be just giving an introduction and I'll be giving you whatever I understood, guys. So if you are searching for a particular video, like I should need 100% clarity and everything, so this is not the correct video for you guys. Okay, so let us continue. So basically jitter control. So jitter may be defined as the variation in delay from the pack for the packets belonging to the same flow. So assume that there are multiple packets going, guys. So due to some situations, there could be some delay, right? So the first packet reached at 1 second and the second packet reached at 2.02 seconds, but it should reach at 2 seconds. So there is a minute delay, right? So this is nothing but jitter control, guys. So the variation in the packet arrival time is nothing but jitter. Okay, so practically we can say that 99% packets should be delivered within a delay range of 24.5 milliseconds to 22.5 milliseconds. So sorry, it should be 25.0, guys, sorry. Okay, so in between that range only it should be there. Okay, so these are the two graphs for minimum and maximum jitter, guys. Okay, I didn't understand anything in these graphs, so you can just go through them. Okay, so here it is nothing but the jitter is high and here the jitter is low. Okay, so he gave that this is the delay and he is informing us that here the jitter is high. So basically here delay is more, like in between this packet and this packet the delay is high, so that the jitter is high. In that way something he is trying to say, but I didn't get the main point for these two graphs. Okay, so basically jitter control. So jitter control is nothing but you are controlling this jitter to be less or in between these things, at max these things. Okay, so jitter control. When a packet arrives at a router, the router packets will check to see whether the packet is behind or ahead. So basically these packets will not be going directly to the sender to receiver, right? So they visit multiple nodes in between. So at every node we will be checking whether this packet is fast or slow. So fast means, so it should go at 2 seconds, but it went at 1.98 milliseconds or something like that, okay? So if it went that time, so it is fast. So in this situation, I need to make it stop, wait till 2 and then go. I'll be informing like that. But if it is late, like it came at 2.10, then go, run fast. I'll be informing it and I'll be giving a priority to it and I'll be pushing it forward in that way. So when a packet arrives at a router, the router will check to see whether the packet is behind or ahead by time. If the packet is ahead early of the schedule, it will keep and hold it. It will hold it and it will not let it go until the time is up. Else, it is already late, then it will be sending it ASAP. Like it will be pushing it and it will be pushing it out into the packet path in which it should go. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about it. Sorry for not explaining the graphs, guys, because I tried to read from multiple books, but wherever I read, I was not getting the point that they are trying to say. Okay, so I hope everyone got some basic idea. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through congestion control in virtual circuits, guys. Okay, so let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.